to the Foundation for Economic Growth and Welfare. As we all know, this is a policy-oriented research think tank, and we believe that the research should fully support policy, advice, and policy actions. Therefore, the Foundation for Economic Growth and Welfare, for nearly a year now, has focused on bringing the most contemporary issues and discuss it in detail, which impact the Indian economy. It is in this context that we have had the privilege of inviting the best minds from across the world, working on India or issues that India is interested in. We have had two Nobel laureates speak to us during this journey, as well as many people from Harvard, Stanford also have spoken to us. Within our country, we have had the best minds also speak to us. Just 2 days back, a very important report was released by the Niti Aayog on health. Dr. Ratan Chand, who's the founding member of the IGRO Foundation, is an expert on health and brings the richness of nearly 35 years of experience of working on these issues. He has worked long years in the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and since his retirement, he has worked extensively with the World Bank and Niti Aayog. The report that he's presenting today, and he will go into the details, he has been associated with it for a long time. He is the national monitor of our country. That means he's closely associated with issues related to health. And when this report was being presented at Niti Aayog, we thought it will be of great interest to our own audience that he speaks to us. Also help us understand the report, as well as tell us where the health issues are in this country. As you all know, this is an important burning issue for all of us for the last 2 years now. With this, I'll invite Dr. Ratan Chand to present his views on the health report, which he has worked extensively and on which he is quite authoritative. Dr. Ratan Chand, please.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Charan. I will make presentation now. So let me share the screen. Okay. Is this visible now, screen?
Visible, sir.
Okay.
It is visible.
Okay. So, as pointed out by Dr. Charan Singh, I will be discussing the State Health Index, which is being prepared for the last 4 years. And the most recent report was released on 27th of December. I think day before yesterday. So how it started, this concept of health index, it started sometimes in 2016. I mean, the discussion started, how should we select indicators, how many indicators should be there, and what should be the methodology. And for this, there were discussions among Niti Aayog, Ministry of Health, states, repeated discussion took place. And for this, expert inputs were taken from the national as well as the international experts. And while doing so, because many people suggested many indicators, so this was indicators were pre-tested in the states whether data is available or not. So after all this, this index was finalized with the inputs which we got from the states and other experts sometime in December 2016. So after finalizing, it was circulated to the states for getting the information. So, So far we have got we have released four reports starting from the year 2015-16. 2015-16, when I'm saying that, means data of 2015-16 and 2014-15. We take 2015-16 as the reference year, 2014-15 as the base year. So similarly, in the second round, 2017-18 was the reference year, and third round 2018-19 was the reference year, and for the recent round 2019-20 is the reference year. So this is the thing. And the background health index, this is a weighted composite measure of state UT's performance on health outcomes and health systems. Health index scores and rankings for states and UTs are generated to assess incremental performance, that year-to-year progress, and also the overall performance for the current year. The fourth round of health index, 2019-20, examined the overall performance and incremental performance for the period 2018 is the base year to 2019-20, which is the reference year. Okay, so this index follows a robust mechanism for measuring the performance. Data is collected online through the portal maintained at the Niti Aayog on all the agreed indicators, and data is validated by an independent validation agency, which is selected through a transparent bidding process. The validated data sheets are shared with the states for confirmation, and this is followed by a video conferencing with the states for resolving any disagreement or inconsistencies in the data. So data set thus finalized, then this are shared with the states, and after using this finalized data, this is used for index calculation, analysis, and report writing. Okay, so this is the brief methodology. We have around 24 indicators. We will see the indicator, what are the indicators. So some are positive indicators, some are negative indicators. When we say positive indicators, we say for immunization, as it increases, it's a positive indicator. If it is 80%, it will be good. We have 85% or 90% of immunization. And negative indicators are those, for example, mortality indicator, neonatal mortality or under 5 mortality. These mean we expect decrease in these indicators. It is not good to have a increase in these indicators, so these are called negative indicators, just for our understanding. So minimum and maximum values for the indicators are resultant on the values of this indicator, of the indicators across the states. So for the positive indicators, this equation above, as you can see, it is used for scaling the values, normalizing the values, and for the negative indicators, the second equation is used. So after we got this, after we get this scaled values, we then we compute a weighted index, composite index, we say. So the formula is given, summation of WISI divided by WI. This is a weighted average formula, very simple. And achievement and of the states is displayed on the basis of reference year index score, as well as incremental changes from base year to reference year. So this is the brief methodology of this. So this is the mean indicators and weights attached to the indicators. So in this round, we had 24 indicators for the larger states. 18 for smaller states and 15 for UTs. So why these are varying number of indicators? Because we don't have data for all the indicators for the smaller states and small union territories. So that's why for the largest states we have 24 indicators, and out of these 24 indicators, only 18 has data for smaller state and 15 has data for union territories. So on the same lines, we have I will tell you later. The index is separately prepared for larger states, smaller states, and union territories. So that's similar comparisons is made among the smaller states, among the larger states, and among the UTs. So we will quickly go through the indicators to have an idea in what are the indicators that are taken in this index. So in fact, in this index we have covered three domains. One is the health domain, health outcomes domain. Second is governance and information. Then third is key inputs and processes. So in the health outcome domains, again, we have two subdomains, key outcomes and intermediate outcomes. So in the key outcomes, indicators, four indicators were taken this time. These are neonatal mortality rate, under 5 mortality rate, sex ratio at birth, and maternal mortality ratio. In the case of intermediate outcome, 7 indicators were taken: the modern contraceptive prevalence rate, full immunization coverage, then ANC registered within the first trimester, pregnant women received 4 or more antenatal cares, institutional deliveries, case notification of tuberculosis, then tuberculosis treatment success rate, then people living with HIV on antiretroviral therapy. So these were intermediate outcomes. In the governance and information, one of the indicators which we took was the data integrity. When the states are reporting data on HMIS, whether how much they vary from the standard surveys. So this time this NFHS 5 was not available, but when we were doing work on this report, now it is available. So we used SRS data, which is available for the larger states only. And another governance indicators is the average occupancy. I mean, during the last 3 years, what is the average occupancy of key officers at the state level? Key officer mean principal secretary, mission director, director of health services. Because it has been the tendency of the states to shift the officers quite frequently, which affect the implementation of the health programs. So this was one of the indicators. Similarly, at the district level, district CMO, chief medical officer, is an important officer. So what was the average occupancy of all the CMOs taken together? Suppose a district, a state has 40 districts, then what is the average for the 40 districts during the last 3 years for a CMO? So this was taken. And another important thing is central government transfer money to the states, but it keeps lying many a times at the state level. It is not further released to the implementation agencies. So this number of days taken to transfer this fund from the state treasury to the implementation agency, this was also taken as one of the governance indicator. Another domain, this key inputs and processes domain, around 9 indicators, but there are many sub indicators also. 9 indicators were taken mainly. So one of the first indicator in this domain was short term of healthcare providers in public health facility. This includes these nurse midwives at the sub centers, staff nurses at primary health centers, urban primary health centers, community health centers, and urban community health centers. Medical officer at PSCs, at UPSC, specialists at district hospitals. So this was the main all the staff at these facilities, and this type of staff, the shortfall was measured and used in the index. Then next indicator was staff covered under a functional human resources management information system. So this is good, whether the states have developed any system for computerizing all of data of their staff and to be used in transfer posting, release of salaries, etc., etc. So this was also taken as one of the indicator. Then functional first referral units. This is very important in the peripheral level, because at the peripheral level we have sub center, then primary health center, and community health center. So ideally, every community health center should be a first referral unit. I mean, they should provide the specialist services. And another indicator was public health facilities with Kayakalp score of 70%. So Kayakalp is a program implemented by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, mainly to keep to improve the upkeep of the physical upkeep of the, you can say, of the facility. Then another indicator is functional health and wellness center. Government of India has launched a scheme to convert the sub centers and the primary health centers into the health and wellness centers by providing a community health services and other facilities so that they can provide a better package of the services. Another indicator is district hospital with functional cardiac care unit. And level of registration of births, level of registration of deaths, then completeness of integrated disease surveillance program. This is reporting about P and L form. And there is public health facility with accreditation certificates and district hospital and CSCs certified under Lakshya, labor room and maternity. And state government health expenditure to total expenditure. So these were the 24 indicators. Out of these, we see 18 were available for the smaller states and 15 for the union territories. Why this stopped? What happened? Okay, so data sources were mainly sample registration system, health management information system, civil registration system, then the program management information system of the, say, tuberculosis, AIDS, HIV AIDS, then integrated disease surveillance and national health mission. In addition to this, also data from the states was the main source. As I told earlier, we generated the index in three categories for larger states, smaller states, and union territories. In the case of union territories, data for Ladakh was not included, and among the larger states, West Bengal did not participate in this exercise. So we should have 20 states instead of 20. Now we 19 results are presented for 19 states only. So many of the indicators included in the index are also the SDG indicators or SDG targets. These include this neonatal mortality rate, under 5 mortality rate, MMR, maternal mortality, institutional deliveries, then case notification of TB. And the same thing, HIV, etc., child immunization, pregnancy care, health workforce. So all these are also part of the SDG SDG indicators. So having said that, the index has certain limitations. Some of these I have already said. So this is a work in progress, and continuous refinements are made as additional quality data becomes available and the data system improves. So due to this, mean indicators, some of the indicators are dropped, some are added. So due to this, I think index is not then comparable over time. That is one of the problem. Some critical areas such as infectious diseases, non-communicable diseases, mental health, governance, financial risk protection are not fully captured in the health index due to non-availability of data. Non-availability or periodicity is not good, mean it's not available on annual basis. Several indicators that is limited to service delivery in the public facilities due to paucity and uneven availability of private sector data on health services in the HMIS. For outcome indicators such as neonatal mortality rate, under 5 mortality rate, maternal mortality ratio, sex ratio at birth, I mean these data are available only for larger states. So there's a limitation I told earlier. Several indicators, HMIS data and program data were used without any field verification. Lack of feasibility of conducting independent field survey. HMIS, different staffs are reporting. So sometimes there could be reporting bias. So we could not verify how much is that. So we have used the HMIS data as available. So results are not comparable over rounds, as I told you earlier, due to inclusion of new indicators, definition is refined, or varying number of states, varying number of participating states or UTs. So now we come to the results. In what we got from the whole exercise. So this is a little bit looks complicated picture, but not that complicated. But it can this information this picture has lots of information. If you see this left hand side, if you see. These are the base year mean 2018-19 ranking of states from 1 to 19. On the right hand side, this is the ranking of states for the year 2019-20. In the circles, index scores are given. And the yellow lines indicate which are very straight lines, parallel lines. These lines indicate there is no change in the rank of the states. Green line indicates increase in the state has improved. Red line means the rank of the state has come down in the reference. So if we see this, many of the states retained their rank from base year to reference year. You can just count this yellow line. Yeah, I think these are more than these were 10 line must be there. So there was no change in the rank of 10 states. Kerala retained the rank. It remained at the top. It was at the top in 2018-19, still in the at the in 2019-20. UP was at the bottom in both the years 18-19 and 19-20. So this you can see I don't have to say much about. You can see, say for example, Telangana, it improved its rank from 4th to 3rd, Gujarat from 7 to 6, Karnataka, I think its rank came down from 8 to 9, for Odisha it came down 12 to somewhere in 14, or like that. But these four states, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, There was no change in the rank. They remained at the bottom of all the states. Okay, so this is the first thing which came out from this report. And next thing which we want to say that there are huge variation in the index scores. This is for 2019-20. At the one end is Kerala, and at the another end is Uttar Pradesh. So Kerala has 82.2 index score and Uttar Pradesh has 30.57. So there is a lot of distance yet to be covered to achieve their full potential for many of the states. So that is the important message from this. Now we come to the changes from the base year to the reference year. So the first, these are first part of these bars, if you see, this is the same which earlier we have presented in a by ranking the states. Now these are jumbled up because now we have sorted the data on the incremental change. So the middle part of this figure is the incremental change which took place. And another last two columns are the reference year rank and the incremental rank. Incremental rank is mean ranking based on the middle part, mean this green one and red one. So we see that Uttar Pradesh has the highest incremental score, followed by Assam, Telangana, Maharashtra, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, and up to Odisha. Then at the bottom is Karnataka. The mean, instead of improvement in from base year to reference year, its index score declined. So at the top was Uttar Pradesh for incremental performance, and at the bottom it is Karnataka. So we have just seen in one is overall rank, current performance, one is incremental performance. So when we cross classify this data, overall performance by incremental performance, then we see this. Let me explain you what is aspirants, what are achievers, what are front runners. In fact, aspirant states are the bottom one third, achievers are middle one third, and front runners are top one third states. Okay. So, and this incremental performance not improved means negative performance, like we saw the Karnataka. And others are these least improved, mean their index score increased between 0.01 to 2 and moderately improved from 2 to 4 and most improved more than 4. So when we classify this, then we see at the right end, Telangana is the state which has done well both in overall performance and incremental performance. It is a front runner and also it is most improved. Okay. There were these other front runners, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, they also improved, but their improvement was less than 2%, less than 2%. Moderately improved. Maharashtra is also a front runner, but it is moderately improved. And Telangana is the it has done well both in incremental as well as overall performance. In the say, if we take this one third these aspirants, then you see Uttar Pradesh was among the one third state, but it is the most improved along with Assam and Uttar Pradesh. Assam also did well. But if you see Rajasthan, it is among the bottom one third, and it also did not improve in the health index according to the health index. So this is a cross classification. One can see how I have performed in the overall and how I have performed in the increment. So this classifies these states in like this. So as I told you in the beginning that there are three domains: health domain, health outcomes domain, governance and information, and key input processes. So these light blue are the health outcomes. Orange one, these are governance and information, and light green are key input and processes. So we, from this chart, we can make out that which states are good in governance and information. For example, this if we see this Gujarat, Chhattisgarh, Assam, Odisha, Uttarakhand, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and other two states, not these are covered. These are good. I mean, they have highest scores in the governance and information compared to any other domain. So there are many states which have done well in health outcomes. These are light blue balloons, you can see. And only few have done well in key input processes. Okay. So this is the main, all the domains at one place. You can make out which state has done well in governance, which has done well in health outcomes, and which has done well in key input processes. So this is another interesting graph. I told you that there are 24 indicators, but in the 24 indicators, for one indicator, there are many sub indicators. So if we count all of them, for the larger states, it becomes 43 indicators. So this is the distribution of those 43, mean how many have improved, how many have most improved, how many remain static, how many indicators deteriorated, and how many most deteriorated. And some are not applicable indicators also show this. So if we see Uttar Pradesh, it improved in, it led in improving 33 indicators out of 43 indicators. On the other hand, Kerala led in improvement of 19 or 22 indicators. So if you see this dark green and white figures, actually these are the number of indicators in which these states have fully achieved their potential. For example, if some state have achieved 100% immunization, there is no scope for further improvement. So these are the number of indicators which are fully improved. So at one shot, states can see whether they are in how many indicators they are doing well or they are doing worse. This is the indicator. So this was regarding the larger states. Similar set of figures is for smaller states and UTs. So we can go through that. This is for smaller states. Only Nagaland, it retained its, it remained at the bottom, and there was no change in the rank of Nagaland from base year to the reference year. The other states, Mizoram, Sikkim improved their rank. Then Tripura, Goa, they come down. As you can see, by the red lines, green line is improvement, red line is deterioration, and yellow line is means same rank. In this, in the case of smaller states, again, there is quite a distance to be traveled to reach the frontiers. As the lowest score is for Nagaland 27 only, and okay, somebody else, I kindly request you to mute. Okay, so in case of incremental performance of the smaller states, Mizoram is at the top, these middle one, if you see this thing, then this is the incremental performance. Mizoram is the top, followed by Meghalaya and Nagaland, and the worst performance is by Goa. So similar to the larger states, if we see the cross classification among the overall performance and the incremental performance, then Mizoram did well both in overall and incremental, whereas these Arunachal Pradesh and Manipur, they did worse in both the aspects, overall performance as well as incremental performance. So Meghalaya, although it was among the bottom one third states, it improved its performance from this year to reference year quite significantly. So this is the situation again for the three domains, for the smaller states. Here the health outcome domains is prominent among many states. You can see these light blue balloons. It is topping in almost all the smaller states except say Goa. Okay. This is again the distribution of the number of indicators. Tripura is at the top in improvements and Sikkim at the bottom. In case of the union territories, there was lot of reshuffling in the ranks. Many UTs improved their ranks. In fact, four UTs improved ranks, three deteriorated. As you can see in the graph itself, it's clear. Dadar and Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu, TH and DD, this is combined acronym. It is in the top during the reference year, and Andaman and Nicobar at the bottom. Again, there is a lot of distance to travel to the frontiers. Incremental performance improved in four UTs, but deteriorated in two UTs. And in case of UTs, when there is no UT which performed well, performed best in overall as well as incremental. If we see there were two UTs which front runners, that is among the top one third states, but they did not improve their rank, improve their index score from base year to the reference year. On the other hand, Delhi, Jammu Kashmir, and Lakshadweep, these were the bottom one third, but they improved a lot from base year to the reference year. In the case of UTs, again, these health outcomes is the prominent domain. Where the performance of the UTs was the best. Again, number of indicators where UTs did well and or worse, one can see from this graph very easily. So in summary, if we see overall performance, which are the states with improved rank, with retained rank, which deteriorated their ranks? Well, this is given in this graph. In the largest states, four states improved rank, 10 retained their rank, remained at the same level, and five, they deteriorated in the rank. In the case of smaller states, three states improved rank, one state retained its base year rank, and rank of the four state deteriorated. In the case of UTs, all the four UTs improved ranks. There is no UT that retained their base year ranks, and three UTs observed registered decline in the ranks. In the case of incremental performance, larger states, you can see 14 states improved their rank, improved incremental performance, and five observed decline in the performance from base year to the reference year. Similarly, smaller state, four states observed improvement and four observed deterioration. In the case of UTs, five UTs observed improvement and two UTs observed decline. Okay. So this is all in the report, mean for the use of the states, what we are doing, we are giving heat maps. For example, this is, I have just for demonstration shown only two indicators, E. coli immunization and first trimester AMC. But if you, the states can see immediately, what was their values, for example, full immunization, what was their value in the base year, and what is now their values. Then in the next column, increment mean how much they have improved. So looking at this, we can find out which are the states which have improved most. Suppose we take a range of all the states which have improved. Then again, we divide that range into two parts, which have improved and which have most improved. The first half is improved and other remaining part is most improved. So dark green is most improved. This is also seen mean by the increment. In other cases, there is small number 1.29, 0.74. But in the case of Meghalaya, they improved their performance from 59% to 100%. So that is an increase of 40.51. But looking at this this type of table in which is given in the report, all states can see mean where do I stand, the state can see mean vis-a-vis other states. In the case of base year and reference year figures, again, one can make out mean these red figures shows that I am among the bottom 1/3 states, and green figure shows I am among the top 1/3, and the black figure shows I am among the middle 1/3 states. So looking at this one table, in for any indicator, states can see where I was in the base year, where I am now in the reference year, whether I have made any improvement from base year to reference year. For all the these 43 indicators, one can see. This is all data given in the report. In addition to that, for every state, a fact sheet has been made available, which gives all the indicators and indicator value for the in the beginning you see this this gives the index values and whether this in this state is a front runner, achiever or aspirant. So that value is given, then incremental where it is least improved, most improved or like that. So that value is that information is also given, and for all the indicators the 2019-20 indicator values are given, and whether that indicators have improved, deteriorated or remain stagnant. Yellow is stagnant, light green is improved, then this dark green is most improved, and this this dark yellow is deteriorated, and red one is most deteriorated, like that. And for example, this here we see this zero value is zero, so and it remained zero, and it is it cannot be achievement cannot be more than this. This zero means there is no shortfall of medical officers in the states. So it was zero in the base year, it remained in zero in the base year, and that's why increment is 0.0. And they have achieved their full capacity. So a state can make out which are the indicators where I'm lagging, which are the indicators where I'm making the progress. So because this index is being made, is being generated and released since using data from 2014. So 2014 to 2018 data we have given in the report. All the data, time series you can see or the common indicator. The indicator which have changed in between, nothing can be done. So here you see from 2014 to 2018. 2019 data for this new determinant mortality rate, etc., was not available. It has not been released even today. So we only this much was used, and what the time series data is given here. Okay, so what can we learn from all this? This whole this health index exercise promoting healthy competition. It is enhancing accountability and ownership at the highest level, because this index is reviewed at the highest level at the additional chief secretary or health principal secretary level. So there is a consciousness among the officers to improve the data quality, to be associated with this. And one important thing is that the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare is also has also linked this its incentive amount with this index. I mean, they release around 10% of the total budget based on this index. If the state has done well, then they are releasing. Otherwise, some may not be releasing. Exact, I don't know, but yes, they have. They are using the index for giving incentives to the states. Okay, and this is an independent exercise. I mean, transparent exercise. Data is validated by the third party, and then World Bank is writing the report at a arm's length from the Niti Aayog. So this is a fair. I mean, we can say. Is an independent, fairly transparent exercise. It is another thing if the data quality is not good, then nothing can be done. But data is validated, thoroughly validated to the extent possible. That is also there. Okay. And institutionalization in now Niti Aayog or the government. We can institutionalize it for the future. This is also somewhat linked to the previous one. I mean, using the methodology here, states can rank districts using this methodology, and they can compete and they can create a healthy competition among the states, among the districts, as in the case of states. So, because the data, the indicators which come into the index, the states become conscious about those indicators, and they put extra efforts to improve their performance, to maintain data quality, and better program management, better review. States can identify the indicators responsible for low ranking. Heat maps and fact sheets, which I just demonstrate, show. They can make use of these heat maps and fact sheets to improve, to take action regarding those indicators. Share best practices among themselves. So while doing this, some of the states they have done next. Extremely well, some have not done. They can share the experience. The states which have done extremely well, they can share the experience how they attained this distinction. So that process is also has been suggested to the I think the Niti Aayog is aware of that, and they may be taking action on that. Then Ministry of Health and Family Welfare bringing indicators of program important programs under the index. So program officers, they feel if my indicator comes in the index, my monitoring will be better and my implementation of the program will also be better. So they feel like that. So I think this is just so many indicators indicators were dropped, new indicators and definition were improved in the last round, and the current round also. Some of the indicators, one indicator was dropped, three were newly added, and the definition of two indicators were refined. So this is all I have to say. Thank you very much. So I have to stop this. Okay.
Dr. Ratan, we must thank you for giving us such an elaborate presentation. You have covered almost everything. All the questions that I had in my mind, especially the ones on incentivizing, the way you have covered it is a very, very, I would say it's a very, very comprehensive presentation that you have made. There are a few questions in the chat box. Do you want to take some of them? And we would like to open it for discussion now. If there are any questions, you can raise your hand.
If you have in the chat box, can you read out? And
See, one question was here is one question from Vasdani. Is it a census data or a sampling process was used?
No, I told you the sources of data is one is health management information system, which is elaborate and being implemented by the Ministry of Health. Second source was sample registration system for all the health outcome indicators like neonatal mortality rate, under 5 mortality rate, sex ratio at birth, and maternal mortality ratio. This is SRS data. Also registration of births, deaths. This is civil registration data. So this is not mean, this is all data from the established sources and from the programs.
Now, the second question, again, from Vasdani, what was the unit of analysis?
I don't understand that.
If Vasdani is in the audience, would you like to ask your question, please?
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for a very nice presentation, sir. It gave us a complete scenario of the health status in India. Thank you very much, sir. There's some few questions that occurred to me when you were presenting, sir. The unit of analysis was again related to how data was collected. You did mention that there were a lot of information system, management information system from which you derived this data, as you were mentioning. But was this data collected at the hospital level, at a primary health center level, or it was at the household level? Because I was worried about a subsequent question, is that whether there was an undercoverage of the data, did the data have a limitation of undercoverage of these participants?
So I think I made it clear. Sample registration system is a nationwide survey, if you are aware. I think it covers around 7 lakh households. So it's a very elaborate independent survey implemented by the Registrar General of India. Okay, that is the main source of this data, published data. Another is this health management information system. So in the country, there are around 2 lakh facilities, health facilities. All these, I think 99% of these facilities, they report on the HMIS. So this is a sort of a complete census, you can see, and this data is automatically compiled through the system and the reports are generated. So most data is taken from the health management information system. Again, the civil registration system, this is a data, this is being implemented by the Registrar General of India again. So this is throughout the country. This data is being generated for all the states, so that is used. When you say these data is being collected from the hospitals, yes, a 2 lakh facility, I'm telling, they are reporting themselves each month, and this data is being compiled, analyzed through the system itself. Okay. Any other question?
Dr. Ratan, there's a question from Dr. Anandu. Should we, Dr. Anandu, do you want to say your own question?
Actually, sir, a nice presentation. Just I was curious about the maximum values and the minimum values of the Z score computed and how the weights were determined.
You see, maximum minimum is very easy to determine. No? I mean, you have a value for say 20 states, and which state has that? I mean, what is the maximum value among those, and what is the minimum value? One can easily find. You just sort out, or in the Excel you write maximum of here to here, so you get the maximum value and minimum value also. You get like that. Okay, so what was your other question?
I was curious about the weights too. Actually, maximum values, some in the HDI we see some are the targeted according to SDGs. So therefore, the maximum values are there according to the SDGs. That is what I was.
Yeah, we took from the data itself. We have not set the frontiers like that. Maybe in future we will do that, but for the time being it is taken from the data itself, which is, what is the maximum, what is the minimum. And regarding your second question, again I forgot that. What was that,
sir? About the weights, how did you compute the weights?
Okay, so weights are scientific method of assigning the weights. These are assigned on the basis of expert judgment. I mean, it is between the health ministry, between the Niti Aayog and the states. I mean, which indicator should get what weight? But mostly, what is done that ultimately, I mean, our objective is to attain minimum neonatal mortality, minimum under 5 mortality, minimum maternal mortality. So these indicators have been given approximately, I think 70% of the bed goes to the health outcome indicators, and the rest of the 30% goes to the governance and also to the key input processes. The rationale is, I think, is quite good, because if someone is keep on adding inputs but not achieving the outcomes, then what is the use of that? So accordingly, the weights have been given based on the expert judgments. Okay.
I think. Are there any questions? Otherwise, I have one basic question. Dr. Ratan, I wasn't very sure. Maybe you have covered it. I wasn't very sure. How did you make the distinction between the larger states and the smaller states? And why I asked that question is that when I looked at the data classification, I found Himachal was in the larger states, whereas most of the northeastern states were in the smaller states. So what was the defining line?
Actually, we have not taken that into account, like population, etc. It is the classification done by the Registrar General of India when they release this when they are releasing this data, say birth rate, death rate, infant mortality rate, etc. So they have classified, these are, they call it bigger state, smaller state, and union territories. So you just use that classification. You can say it is mainly driven from the data available.
Right. Also wanted to check with you, when there is a sharp decline, for example, I saw there's a substantial decline in Himachal, then there's a substantial decline in Sikkim. My own thought was that in Himachal, one can understand hilly state, so maybe there are some reasons. But Sikkim is pretty good. I wasn't very sure. So when you see I understand when a state does well, you have incentives. But when there is a decline, are there any corrective measures which you suggest and recommend the states to do? Or is it just that incentive which you mentioned should work its way?
Actually, incentives, we don't, I mean, we don't recommend. This is Ministry of Health has adopted this for giving incentives. They, I think they give some of these things. I mean, they cut money also. So I'm not aware about that. They have, what process exactly they are following, but yes, they are making use of this.
So there's a negative, there's a disincentive also.
And, in Madhya Pradesh and Sikkim, it all depends on this game. I mean, whether they have performed from the base year to the reference year, they have performed better on the indicators or not. They may be better in the last year. If the you know, if the program officer is good and he's doing everything improves. If the program officer is lethargic, then everything goes slow. So it can be, I mean, due to the, it is due to those, and one can easily identify, I mean, which are the indicators where they are lagging. As I show you the heat maps, the, then the fact sheet of the state, they can find out, I mean, where am I lagging? Lagging.
Right. If there are no more questions, we have reached the end of our time. We have
Hello, sir. I have a question.
Please go ahead.
Sir, as the report said, Kerala is the best state on health parameters, but in just 2 days on Christmas, Kerala drunk liquors worth 150 crores in just 2 days. Sir, my question is, does health indicator shows the actual real health status of people of the state?
No, madam, I did not understand your question. What is the exact question?
Sir, does health indicator shows the actual health status of people of the Kerala state? Because Kerala is the best state on health parameter, but they drunk much.
What is that?
They drunk liquor.
Drunk.
Yes, sir.
Unfortunately, we don't have any indicator on the alcoholism or the related thing, because the data is mean mostly this type of a survey is done, say, then it doesn't get updated. So, but we are making data which is we are using data which is available at least on annual basis. So such data, they are not available on the annual basis. That is the problem. So this aspect is not included in that.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
I would like to supplement, Dr. Ratan, if you will agree. I'd like to supplement your answer by saying that the health indicator report has clearly delineated the parameters that they take into account. Now, there can be many other things that are happening in the state. One could be the one which you mentioned, that people use use liquor or use other things and get impacted. But because it's not in the monitorable indicators, which are so well defined in the report, this doesn't reflect. Would that be an appropriate supplement to you, Dr. Ratan?
Yes, yes.
There are two more questions. One is from Mubarak Ali and one is from Avdesh Yadav. I would request each one of you to ask your own questions. Can Mubarak Ali go first?
Good afternoon to all. Respected sir, thanks for your invaluable insight. Extending my sincere thanks to organizers for this opportunity. My question is, the world is head for 2022. What are the major challenges and opportunities for India to head for health and family welfare? And thanks for the opportunity.
Dr. Ratan, do you want to take the other question also and then answer them together?
No, I have not understood his question actually. There's some voice is breaking.
Mubarak, do you want to repeat your question?
I will repeat you, sir. Thanks for your invaluable sir.
Your voice is breaking actually.
Okay.
Mubarak,
I'm audible sir right now?
No, to me yes, also sir. The voice is breaking, but I'm making a suggestion. You please speak your question. If I am able to capture it, I'll translate it for Dr. Ratan, or I'll tell you to write it in the chat box. So first go ahead, please repeat your question.
The world heading 2022, what are the major challenges and opportunities for India to head for health and family welfare?
Okay. So Dr. Ratan, the question he's asking is for the ensuing year, what are the major challenges in the national health and family welfare?
Okay, this is a very, I think, big question. What are the challenges? But as in layman, we can say that, yes, managing the pandemic is most important than providing services to the general public during the pandemic. And I think all other health programs are being implemented. That's okay, but the challenges are the pandemic challenges, according to me.
Yes. All right. Now, there's a Avidesh Yadav. Do you want to ask your question?
Yes, sir. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Sir, I just wanted to ask that the current health coverage, the program that has been started by the central government, that is Ayush, perhaps. So, how much is it effective in the covering the overall the population that it claimed that the 40 crore population has been covered under the Ayush program? So what are the improvements are needed in that? Can you comment on that?
Unfortunately, not much data from the Ayush sector we have covered. Only health and wellness centers, they are supposed to mean at some of the centers, the Ayush practitioner is also provided at the primary health center. So, but not we have not segregated what is the impact of Ayush vis-a-vis allopathy.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Ratan, there's one Charan, question.
Yeah, Ratan, yeah. I asked one question. Just a comment.
Sure.
Yeah, Dr. Ratan.
Anji.
Yes. I heard partly yours because I had some my. So, but I partly heard, but whatever I heard, it was a wonderful, wonderful presentation, masterful exposition. And this is absolutely top class stuff. And that is, I just wanted to congratulate you. And the question I was listening, Charan Singh and others asked, and that was very good. That's it. But I think you covered a very good ground with a lot of width. So, once again, congratulations to you. I enjoyed whatever I heard.
Thank you very much.
There's one question from this gentleman who just joined a little late, Arkitesh, if I pronounced it properly. And his question is, will COVID change the rankings? I mean, how would COVID impact? Any views that you would have, Dr. Ratan?
Now the thing is, this report which was released doesn't cover COVID period because it was 2019-20, isn't it? So it will depend, it will change definitely. I mean, the states which most of the indicators are, you can see these are health indicators. So the states which have provided services, which will have higher indicators, which have not provided services will have lower indicators. So that will be reflected there definitely. Okay. So and the states which have maintained mean past performance, they will be at the same level or they will get better.
I must thank Dr. Ratan and the participants for making the discussion so rich. Dr. Ratan, of course, gave us a very, as Dr. Vishen Das was saying, a masterful presentation. There's no doubt about it. He gave he covered it, and the presentation was very, very comprehensive. Really, thank you, Dr. Ratan, for preparing such a good presentation within such a short time. The report has just been presented 2 days ago, and you've enlightened all of us with your analysis, starting from basic methodology, basic facts, and then your own analysis. So we are thankful to you. I'm also thankful to the participants for having asked such good questions, which enriched the discussion. The presentation will be available on our website tomorrow. You can use it for various purposes. And on Friday, we are again having a special session. This is on vulnerable segments of the society, and it is being provided by Professor Ishita, Department of Psychology, Delhi University. She has just completed editing a book, and basically this is a presentation on the book. Professor Ishita has written 3 chapters. She'll be there. Her co-authors will be there to tell us about the book. And basically, the book is going to talk about vulnerable segments of the society. I've had a preview of it, and I can tell you this is going to be a mind-blowing presentation on Friday also. I would invite all of you to please join us on Friday. The presentation will be, we'll send you the flyer, 3:30 to 4:30. So with that, we'll close the session today, wishing you all the best and hoping to look forward to meeting all of you on Friday. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ratan, once again.
Thank you very much.